program at Civicus, Civil Society Behind Bars. He's the president of the Bahrain Center for Human Rights. Please welcome Mr. Nabil Rajab.
Hello, everyone. In fact, I didn't know that I need to speak today because when they invited me 3 months ago, I was banned from traveling. So I told them I'm not going to attend. So, but 2 weeks or 3 weeks earlier, I was allowed to come, and I just called my colleagues here and I said I'm coming. But I forgot that I have to talk. If anybody tweeting among you, I request you, out of what I say, make sure that you put hash Bahrain and my name as well. My name is Nabil Rajab, N-A-B-E-E-L, Rajab, R-A-J-A-B, one word. So my government knows that I'm speaking in front of hundreds of people, civil society leaders, about the crackdown against the civil society. So they know that the crackdown also has a cost in their reputation and image regionally and internationally. As you all know, I've heard of the Arab Spring. Bahrain people in my country were inspired by the revolution of Tunisia and Egypt. And we had our own on 14th of February of this year. We have seen how much the people have broken a wall of silence. We always thought that dictators in the region cannot be changed, cannot be reformed. But Tunisian model have taught us, no, that is not correct. Dictators could be removed and democratic system could be implemented. That has empowered a lot of nations in the region, including my nation. We have seen how much the Western country have taken a side with the revolutions on those countries, supported them. We thought we're going to achieve the same thing. Unfortunately, we were mistaken in our calculation. The government, after we started our revolution, start their campaign against civil society and human rights defenders and human rights organization. On 16th of March, they have sent their troops and army to kill people in the street to stop those people fighting for democracy and human rights. We have many people killed, thousands of people being detained, thousands of people being fired from their work, university, school, mosques being demolished, houses being looted and robbed, villages being raided. Hospital, the only hospital we have, it changed to interrogation and torturing center. Unfortunately, what we have seen from Western government on Egypt and on Libya and Syria, we didn't see it on Bahrain, because Bahrain is an oil state, because Saudi Arabia, which is backing, I mean, before I just go ahead to this, our government did not only crack down using their own army, but they have invited the Saudi army, an army from the GCC and other Emirates, to come and take part in killing people, taking part in the crackdown. We have seen this happening with the silence of international community, or from the Western power, from United States government. We were oppressed by the many government, led by United States government. We were victims of American presence in our country. We were victims of interest of some European countries and Americans. Nobody could criticize Bahrain as they did with Syria, as they did with Libya, as they did with Iran, as they're doing with Egypt. No, why? Because Bahrain is an oil country. And many of those countries, including United States government, unfortunately, seize their interest lie with those dictators in the Gulf country more than with any democratic future of those states. At least 6% of the Bahraini manpower were suspended and fired from work. at least 4 political prisoners for every 1,000 citizens. 4 people died of torture in the past few months. One of them, founder of a newspaper, the other one is a blogger, 2 other activists. Civil society were fired, closed down. Most of the civil society leaders today behind bar, tortured systematically. I thank human rights organization who took this issue to the international level. I took from Bahrain Center for Human Rights, which was closed by the government 2004. But thanks God, today we are more known organization than before because of the oppression of the government. We have hundreds of civil society leaders today behind bar in Bahrain. Many of them systematically tortured. Some of them have died. My colleague who founded the Bahrain Center for Human Rights with me, he's been sentenced to life imprisonment. He's at the same time the MENA region coordinator for an international human rights organization called the Frontline. I'm here seeking your help, and as this is the first time I meet this big group of civil society leaders, and I urge you to help our country. Unfortunately, those miseries, those oppression in our country being ignored by many Western government and United States government. Not only that, by even media. Unfortunately, Al Jazeera, for example, which gave legitimacy to a revolution in the region, it was ignoring our revolution. Why? Why? Just because we are sharing the same political system. We are a group of countries called GCC ruled by families, same been ruling for the past hundreds of years. And Al Jazeera was silent in Bahrain, especially the Arabic one. So I'm urging you, you are the freedom fighter, you are the democracy lovers, you are the people who are gonna do the change. Our revolution is not yet done, is not yet finished, the business is not yet completed. But I'm very optimistic that we're gonna get it done sooner or later, and we're gonna achieve our goal with your support. And I urge you to stand with us and support us. Thank you very much.